So let's talk about how to make the sun look like this in your videos. Hey everyone, Camber here, back with you from my hotel room in China today, and I wanted to tell you how to get the starburst effect from the sun in your videos. And if you're new here, this channel is all about teaching you how to use your camera to make good videos. So if that's you, consider subscribing. So as you can see from some of these examples here, having the sunburst effect can add a pretty interesting element to your scenes. But then the question is, how do we get this effect with your camera? Well, a lot of times you're used to shooting with the aperture wide open so we can get that shallower depth of field for our shots. But for this, you're going to need to have your aperture closed down pretty narrow in order to create diffraction of the light in your lens. So what's basically happening with diffraction is that when light waves pass through a small opening like your aperture diaphragm, the direction is altered, causing them to spread out in a wave pattern when it hits the camera's sensor. Typically when the sun is high in the sky, it's often too bright and overwhelming in order to get a good starburst effect from it. So one of the best times to get a starburst off the sun is when it's low in the sky, such as in the early morning or the late afternoon. And another way to help create the starburst effect off the sun is to position the sun so that it's partially obscured behind another object, such as a tree or the edge of a building, because partially obscuring the sun also serves to amplify the effect of the narrow aperture. And doing this will also increase the contrast in that region of the frame and make the starburst effect even more pronounced. And here's an example of trying to get a starburst effect with a wide open aperture, but as you can see, all it did was give me just a big glow around the light source because the aperture blades were very rounded and didn't diffract the light in the correct way. But once I stopped the aperture down as high as it could go at f22, then it diffracted the light a lot more and created a good starburst effect. And you can also achieve this starburst effect at night with things like street lamps or Christmas lights, but this is more of a photography thing because in order to compensate for the small amount of light getting through from the very narrow aperture, with photography you can just have a very long shutter speed in order to get more light. But with video, since we're restricted to having one shutter speed that's typically double your frame rate in order to get the normal film look, that doesn't leave you with any option but to raise your ISO a lot, and then you're going to get a lot of noise in your video. And you can see in this example here, I took a picture and just had a very long shutter speed in order to have enough light, and you can see those nice starbursts there from the lights. However, with video, as you can see here, I gave it a really slow shutter speed and that made everything very blurry. So then I put the shutter speed back to double the frame rate, and now I just put the ISO really high up, but now it's very grainy and pretty much unusable. So unless you have a lot of lights to light the scene well, it's probably not going to work too well during the nighttime for video. And the type of lens you have will also have an effect on the way the starburst looks, because different lenses are made with different amounts of aperture blades, and with the more blades, there'll be a greater number of points on the starburst. So when the aperture diaphragm forms a polygon instead of a circle, you get that starburst effect. So if you have an even number of aperture blades, you'll get one starburst point per blade extending from the side of each blade, and because the opposite starburst points overlap, an even number of blades creates one visible star point per blade. A six-blade aperture therefore produces a starburst with 6 points. But if you have an aperture with an odd number of blades, the diffraction extends from the blade across the opening where it doesn't intersect with its opposite point. Therefore, because the starburst point doesn't overlap an opposite point, an odd number of blades creates 2 starburst points per blade. So a 7-blade aperture produces a starburst effect with 14 points. And if you look closely and count the number of starburst points here, you'll see that there's 18, and that means that my aperture diaphragm is made up of 9 blades. And that's how you create the starburst effect in your videos. Just stop down the aperture really narrow so that you get that good diffraction of light, and you can add an interesting element to your scenes. And if this video was helpful, just go ahead and hit that thumbs up and let me know down below if you do have any more questions about how to make this process work. And go ahead and subscribe if you haven't. Remember that the only way to get better at something is to practice. So get out there and film something. See you soon.